heavy shoes, too much black, no construction, you know, in the clothes. This is not fashion. You know, I think it's terrible to see that laissez-aller. It's not for me.
There is no one like Audrey Hepburn today.
No.
She had a magic that we got to know not only because of Breakfast at Tiffany's and all of the films, but we also got to know because she was such an eloquent spokesman for UNICEF.
Yeah? Yes, absolutely.
No one like her.
No one.
What was it she had?
You know, to describe Audrey, first, give me a great emotion, but always when we're talking about, I talk about Audrey, it's very emotional for me because she had everything, and you tell absolutely is the truth. She's not only beautiful, she's of talent, she's a great lady, she's very human, and she's very, very loyal, and I like loyalty. When I meet Audrey for the first time, I'm thinking, I don't know Audrey, I know Catherine Hepburn, but I don't know Audrey Hepburn.
So you knew Catherine Hepburn, but did not know Audrey.
No, and suddenly a beautiful and very tiny, skinny person came and asked me to do the dress for Sabrina. And I said, but I think it's difficult because it's a collection time and I don't think I have time to help you. And she asked me, but please, I want to try your clothes. And she tried, and she said, it's perfect. And Billy Wilder said, it's just what we need for Sabrina. And immediately after, we do Funny Face and Breakfast at Tiffany and Love in the Afternoon and all the contemporary movies, we work together. And always, and one is wonderful. She has this own career, and I have my career at the same time, and we work together, you know, for so many years. And when Audrey stopped to do any movies, she continued to work for UNICEF, and she do marvelous things until she died. But she's an extraordinary image, you know, and I think for the rest of the, to the eternity, the image of Audrey is there because she's delicate, she's great, she has everything.
Is this you at the castle?
No, this is.